just try to give people the ability to just be able to take a deep breath.
Yeah.
Have a little bit.
Hey, y'all. Hold on. Waiting. Okay, now we're broadcasting. All right. I'm going to play a little Gold Rush before my shift starts. Then I'm going to start working on my book. Plus, I got to do a shift today. So, yeah. We're going to play a little Gold Rush today. We're still in season two, by the way, for the record. I've not had time to pick up Gold Rush and play Gold Rush. Tomorrow we may play a little Gold Rush or late tonight. I don't know. A lot of stuff I'm doing today in the last several days. I should say I've been doing a lot of stuff in the last couple days that is important for my book writing career and different things. And I do apologize about my wife in the background. I can't control her.
Yeah, I know the feeling. I need to live too.
Cat, be quiet. You're too loud.
Oh my God. It's like
as you can see, September 1st was the last time I played. So, yeah. And it's September 8th. So, it was about 7 days ago. But I've been so busy in real life that it's just been hectic. Now we've recently reopened our Minecraft realms. Since this has happened, and if I got time to play realms this week, I'm going to. But I'm going to try to get as much done this week of my book and try to get that finished up. I'm hoping I can get it all written today and then take my little bit of break to plan out episode 4. Of our Starflash series.
Wow.
Or even better yet, take a break from Starflash and work on another book project, because Christmas season's getting ready to come up. And I'd like to be able to at least get a book written for Christmas. And not just the normal type books that I write. I want to write an entire episode.
Wow. I'll pray for you, definitely. Yeah, see, all my family's dead.
Maybe in September, get some books done, possibly working 2 projects at the same time, or something like that. Cat, keep your voice down. She is way too loud. She's opening her mouth up. She has no idea we're on YouTube. I'm about ready to mute this microphone because she is being way too loud for me. I got 30 minutes worth of work to do. I'm sorry, guys. I'm going to mute this microphone, and I do apologize, but she is being way too loud in the other room. I don't want her. She's opening her mouth up, and she's doing things that is I don't want her doing, and she isn't listening to me. So I'm going to mute the microphone, and I do apologize about my wife's rudeness. I forgot I had to pause the mute because my wife was being loud, and I do apologize, but we're getting back to live broadcast here. So what I'm doing here in this video, just so you know, is basically I'm trying to get as much gold as I possibly can in the process, and my wife has toned down her voice, so if she gets loud again, then I will pause her again. And I do apologize. She's talking to someone on headsets, and she doesn't even realize how loud her voice carries. It's just, it's these stupid headsets. The thing with the headsets that I have on and what she's wearing in the other room is it muffles out most of the noise. So basically, almost all the noises gets muffled out, the external ones. But still yet, with these headsets, it doesn't mute out almost all of the noise. So if she gets loud on the phone, then I have to yell at her and say, shut up. Yeah, I hate telling her that. So, when you see what, if you've noticed what I was doing in the game, of filling up the bucket, which would, you didn't hear me say, in order for us to make sure that we get all of our gold and stuff like that, once you're running the deal, and let's say, for example, you're filling up your entire bucket price in it, and you're starting from scratch, your mats gets filled real quickly with the Frankenstein. So you're spending so much time building up that gold product that you have. But the problem is with the Frankenstein, it goes fast. I could turn around in one session, get possibly right around 56% of the mats full with just one single load. That's how the game works. So if you completely empty out your mats, you completely empty out everything that you're going, you're going to produce a lot more. So it takes about two full loads to get 100% from the Frankenstein all together. And you have to develop something that works. One thing, one trick that you do when you're playing the game, and Wait a minute. These are not the right mats. Oops. Let's go ahead. Get that taken care of. I made a mistake and got the wrong one. The one trick that you're going to, if you're playing this game and you're starting from scratch, the one trick that I'm going to emphasize to you is you create a process for yourself. Now, you've got four different processes that you're going to have to figure out. Okay. One is when you can apply the Frankenstein. Now, just because you're starting off a map, you're not going to have room to fit that Frankenstein in anything. Okay. That's the thing. You have to make that room. Because if we were to start this map, this whole entire cycle from start, right now, I can't use the Frankenstein. Because the Frankenstein is a big piece of equipment. So you got to figure out where you can apply Frankenstein at and how to apply the Frankenstein. Telling her aunt everything about me. And I don't like total strangers knowing anything about me, period. I'm not that type of person. And she has no idea that I can hear everything she's saying. Now, the second phase. There's two different phases that we work with in the game. The first phase is what we're doing right now, which is taking out the mats. Then you process the mats. So basically, you have to collect the mats, period. If you don't process the mats, then you're going to wind up having trouble. Because basically, all of your supply, every 100% of what you do is with the mats. Only a third of your money comes from the buckets that you collect. Okay, a third. The mats is what collects 70% of your profits altogether. I could turn around and we could start from this, from zero, and show you just how much it does. But keep in mind, the mats are what collects most of your revenue in this game. You're dealing with a lot of mats, and it collects the gold. The gold gets stuck inside the mats. And what you're looking at, which what goes into the buckets, is all of the loose gold that comes into it. So basically, by cleaning the mats, you're cleaning the gold, and the gold is what collects almost everything you did. And then basically your mats are what protects the rest of what you do. So that's the way it works in the game. But there are two forms. And the one thing I'm going to say, this doesn't cover gold that's in gold mines. Let's say, for example, we're talking about the old-fashioned way of doing gold. Because what this is collecting is another way of doing gold. But if you've ever played Minecraft and you deal with Minecraft, well, what the realization of what Minecraft is the same thing. Except you're taking into consideration not just gold, which you won't find underground most of the time. You can find gold veins in real life. But what's in Minecraft is a small portion of pure gold. The gold that you're collecting in Gold Rush, I'm keeping an eye on my clock. The gold that you're collecting in Gold Rush is not pure gold. Because the metals are impure. What you're doing here. So, what is impurity? Impurity is the green stuff that when you smelt the gold, you come in, it produces a lot of what's called impurities in it. So, it gives you kind of a greenish tint. So, you could wind up getting gold that is 60%, has 60% oxide in it. Which means that rust is mixed in with the gold. So what you find in gold mines, and let's say for example inside an actual mine, you're going to get more pure gold from a mine compared to what you're doing in this. This here is not pure gold. The mats weren't 100%, so I'm not going to get a full amount on this cycle compared to normal. If the mats were 100%, I had two mats that was not at 100%. But the fun part starts to begin now. As Oscar would say, we got a little more time. I am actually close to where I normally close my video, but I'm going to try to get these mats done. But I doubt I can do it in 10 minutes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to process this gold. Unfortunately, I don't have time to be able to come in here at this point in time because my shift is starting And for privacy reasons, I can't do videos on YouTube when I am getting ready to do a shift, because of real life takes precedence over the internet. I'm going to try to get as much as I can in the next few minutes here, but I will probably have to close this video in midstream. I was hoping I had plenty of time, but I don't. We're going to have lots of time tonight to get to doing videos on YouTube. But I am going to be spending a lot of time today, for the record, trying to get two things done at once. Doing my job and other things. So I can get a book released to the public. And I am going to be working on another series. I don't know exactly. During the Christmas holidays, I am going to write some Christmas TV shows this year. Just for the record, there is going to be a Christmas TV show that I'm going to be producing and having it available on Amazon.com as a book form. Exactly what the name of this book is, or what the idea is behind the idea behind the Christmas season, but this is going to be my second Christmas season that's going to be coming up. I'm hoping to get this, I'm trying to get this book released now, and then working on probably in episode 4 of our series, may take a break just so I can do one or two books on Christmas, and then come back and finish my other 6 books for the Starflash TV show. And then, come on. I got.
died. My brother, he died in his house. Right by Joanne. Can I say something without you getting mad? She was a little bitch. She could throw the clock.
You guys are hearing everything. She has no idea this is being recorded. Guys, she's giving out too much information. I'm going to have to stop this video. And I do apologize, but she is really, really, she has no idea that all this stuff is being aired on YouTube. I got just a couple more minutes. I'm going to try to get this done. I think I can get it done in 10 minutes. Just I'm only doing this because I gotta hurry up and get to work. All right, so two things we're gonna do. With 93% of magnetite in a bucket, if your magnetite is getting close to 100%, smartest thing for you to do is to put that magnetite into the truck. Which, keep in mind, if you watch two videos ago of Gold Rush on here, my truck is right here. So you can see why I leave buckets in the truck at all times. It's because I collect that magnetite. That's what gives me at least a tenth of my income. If I was just processing gold, I'd only have like a total of 800,000 gold that's in there. But instead, I have almost $1 million worth of gold. We're talking about 900,000. Most of my money that I get from it, I get like 90,000 per buckets of magnetite. So my magnetite investment is what I really focus on after I've upgraded everything. So once you upgraded everything, then you can invest that magnetite into it, and that's going to give you money for the metal. So you're getting metal and you're getting gold at the same time. Magnetite is the impurities. So one more bucket and we are done for the day, because I got to get started on real life stuff. All right, guys. Well, this is Gold Rush. This is Gold Rush the game. You can see very clearly from what we've gathered in this video that we've gotten a lot of work done in the course of 1 hour or in 30 minutes. But I do gotta stop. All right, thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed our Gold Rush video, and I hope you have, well, as soon as I can get my camera, I want to thank you guys for watching, and of course, have a nice day.